show you how to make this quartz clock tick backwards, but also how you can disassemble it and provide you with a general idea and perhaps some inspiration as to how you might incorporate this into your own unique craft or creation. Does that sound titillating to your senses? Wonderful. Let me just put this down for a moment. Delicioso. And some Girl Scout cookies. Favorite caramel delights. They used to be called Samoas, I believe, but I believe that someone complained that that was offensive. Of course, you know how people are these days, so I believe that's why they changed. Samoan, I would be more than happy to have a cookie named after me. But that's just me. So, I hope you have some cookies. Crinkly bag, wouldn't you say? Okay. This is a nice, crispy, crunchy little cookie surrounded by coconut. first thing is, did you know that the clock parts can be taken apart? Each hand pops off from the base. I am not a clock expert. I'm merely a tinkerer. But not only can you take them apart, but you can also order the parts online from various companies that sell the bases. Especially if you wanted to make a custom clock without having to order or purchase an entire clock face and what have you. So, why don't I get started and show you how easy this process is. The first thing I'm going to do is remove the battery. And there you see. Now for the minute hand. There we go. See, there is a nut that screws on to the base, which keeps the clock attached to the face. So we're going to just loosen that by hand. I'm going to hold the base so it doesn't turn as we turn this. Now, many of these quartz clocks are fastened very tight, so you may need a wrench to do this, which is what I had to do, since that is how they come from the manufacturer when the retailer store goes to sell them. So there we have it. You can see. Just a little, I might say a grommet can see, all that I did was just punch a hole into the piece of cardboard to fasten, to push through the little thingamajigger, which turns the hands. So you can make a clock face out of practically anything. Just use your imagination. That's what it's all about. It's about having fun, being yourself, and letting your inner child run amok. Okay, so now for the tricky part, I'm going to need a screwdriver, so just a moment. Most of these have little tabs, sides, and then right here above the battery case. So we're just going to pop open. See, it lifts up, then the other one, there, now we have that lifted up there, and there's just one more tab, there we go, okay, almost up. Gentle, because as soon as you take this off, you're going to expose all the little gears, the plastic little gears that cause the hands to move. So inspired from or found the idea, since I did not come up with this on my own. Okay, so there was I believe an article on Pinterest or about.com, one of those places. So you might want to take a picture if you're not able to remember the order of these gears, because that will be important. Otherwise you may not be able to get the clock to run again. So I've done this a couple of times, so I already know how the gears should go in what order. Okay, so next to each other, like this. Down, and this is what determines how the clock is going to run forwards or backwards. So there is this piece of this wrapped copper wiring that is around this metal thing. I don't know the correct name, but you take this metal thing out and you simply flip it and then you slide it back in, and that's it. This metal piece here, flipping it around, I believe you change the polarity, magnetism or whatnot, that causes the clock to tick one way or the other. Now I've forgotten which way it was in, so we're just going to flip it back in, like that. And you do not want to remove that copper piece, because it is delicately attached to the crystal, the quartz, which is on this little piece of doohickey thing. Now, as I said in the beginning, not all quartz clocks are created equal. Some of these pieces are firmly attached or soldered or fixed in such a way, making it impossible for you to do this and make the clock run backwards. That is why I said you won't know if you'll be able to do it. Take it all the way apart. But if you as I said, most of them you should be able to. You can also talk to the company if you're ordering the parts themselves. They should be able to tell you whether or not it's something you can do. Okay. So, as I said, I'm not sure if I made it go backwards already or not, but we'll just put the clock back and I'll show you. Okay. So now we need to put it back into this little base. See here, there are other little components, little gears, which this will not run without. Sitting on, flip it the opposite way. So let's remove all these little gears. Thank you. sensation, whatever the proper term is flipped around, and the hands will now drive, the gears will now turn the opposite way. Let's put that second hand on there. There we go. And now it is going the correct way. You see? So, that's all that it takes. As I said, sometimes those copper parts and that bracket are permanently fixed. You won't be able to do this, but in most cases, in the three out of four out of five parts that I've encountered, I was able, you know, there's only one of them that I wasn't able to change the speed, but that involves some very in-depth technical savvy, more or less. So I hope just ignore that, it's the rain. To be informative. In the very least, relaxing. I'm just going to put this back on. Twist the nut. There we go. Enjoyable, and as I said, relaxing, hopefully tingling. This is the Tinkerer of Arkham, signing off. It was a pleasure. pleasure. And I hope to see you again in the near future. If you have any requests for